Good afternoon from Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, where today the Eagles go against the Washington Redskins. Hello, everyone. I'm Don Crickey with former Redskin great Sonny Jurgensen. It is a very brisk day here in Philadelphia. Temperature at game time is about 36 degrees, winds gusting up to 25 miles an hour, and your old coach George Allen can't afford too many more losses, maybe none more.
I don't think he can, Don. He's lost three in the division already, and he can't afford to lose a fourth because he's still vying for that wild card spot. They think they have a chance.
Well, he's going to go again with Joe Theismann at quarterback because he can move around, and the Eagles feel they have to contain him, the scrambling.
Joe Theismann was put into the offense to generate some offense, and he's had a little difficulty doing that so far.
His counterpart is Ron Jaworski, coming off his best game. Had a broken thumb the first time these two teams met 2 weeks ago, but he might be ready now.
Had a poor showing against the Redskins 2 weeks ago, 9-27. I'm sure he'd like to have a big day today.
Eagles have a fine defense, sixth in the conference. Marion Campbell is the head defensive coach, and Dick Vermeil, the head coach of the Eagles, says he wouldn't trade Marion Campbell for the number one draft choice in the league. Mark Moseley will be kicking off to lead off the game for the Washington Redskins. And he has the ball teed up, and we are set to go. Wind is going to be a factor in this game. It is a swirling wind. As you look at the flags high above the stadium, you see them blowing in opposite directions as the wind swirls in this bowl-like setting. Moseley into the football, and it is downfield. Going after it is Wilbert Montgomery. He's to the 15, to the 20. Wilbert Montgomery has room to go. And the little guy is all the way out to the 50-yard line. The Eagles are fired up like a college team. It's amazing to watch them come out when their lineups were introduced. There is their quarterback, Jaworski. His setbacks are Sullivan and Hogan. Hogan was out last week with a knee injury. The wide receivers, big Harold Carmichael and very elusive Charlie Smith. The tight end, underrated. Does not get the press he should, Keith Kreftley. And the interior blockers on the Philadelphia offensive line. Eagles breaking the huddle, first and 10 with excellent field position after the good return by Wilbert Montgomery. 46-yard return. Jaworski with men set to either side. Second back through is Tom Sullivan cutting back against the grain. Sullivan rips through the Redskin defensive line and then cuts it down to the 36-yard line. Dusick knocked him down along with a strong safety, Houston. There's the big front four. Ron McDowell, Bill Brundage, Dyron Talbert, and Dennis Johnson. Dusick, McClinton, and Curtis back the line. With Gerard Williams and Joe Lavender, an ex-Eagle at the corners. Ken Houston and Jake Scott, two of the best at the deep safety position. First down on that, Sonny.
Great cutback by Tom Sullivan to pick up 14 yards on the Eagles' very first play from scrimmage.
Well, the Eagles are challenging early as the game is. First back through, cutting down close to the 35 and then knocked back by the Redskins' Curtis. Curtis is picking right where he left off with the Baltimore Colts.
I understand they had a team meeting last night, and a lot of the Redskins got up and voiced their opinions about what was taking place and what they felt should happen. And usually when they have meetings such as that, they come out fired up and play a good football game.
Well, Dick Vermeil says if his team, if our guys can't get up for this one, they shouldn't be in the league. The Eagles really feel a better team than Washington, but as you pointed out, Sonny, the Redskins will fight to when they're backed up, and they are right now the 4-4 record. Three losses in their division. Here is Jaworski taking his time, puts the ball up, and the free football comes down to the 15-yard line as the Redskins set up the defense nicely with Houston and Lavender converging on the receiver.
He went to Ron, looked at the receiver Carmichael much too long then. He never came off of him. He indicated that he wanted to throw the ball to him very early, and he drew a crowd very quickly. It's George Allen. I'm sure he's concerned on this first drive that the Eagles have got on down to their 35-yard line after the big run back.
Third down and 8 now. Big play for the Eagles and the Redskin defense. Jaworski, who leads the NFL in interceptions, he's thrown 16, is too high for his tight end, Kreftley. Brundage put the rush on.
A little mix-up in the pattern then. Kreftley came across the middle, but the back, Hogan coming out of the backfield, actually had a chance to catch a ball, and I think Kreftley thought he was going for it.
The Eagles had a great punting day last week when they beat New Orleans 28-7. The guy that's in there now, Spike Jones, rolled three of them inside the Saints' 10, and he had them backed up all day. He kicks a weird punt on this field. You kind of chip shot it right down a lobe and try to roll it in. There's the deep man, Eddie Brown. There it is. Angles it in, and he does it again. He gets it down inside the 15-yard line. It's going to be out of bounds at about the 12. So the Redskins will get the football for the first time, but they'll start out in the hole. As Spike Jones does his job, he's not a deep punter, but he is an accurate one placing the ball. The Heisman at quarterback, Mike Thomas will probably get the football a lot at one setback, Clarence Harmon, the rookie, at the other.
And the wide receivers, Danny Buggs and Frank Grant and Gene Fugit, have an outstanding year, 25 receptions so far at the tight end. The offensive line, Stokes, Saul, Hoss, Hermerling, and Stark.
First and 10 now for the Redskins. We have no score in the first quarter. The Eagles are very tough against the run. Mike Thomas gets the call as they try to run a quick trap. Eagle defense, very strong against the run. They play the 3-4. Manny Sistrunk, their ex-Redskin at one end. The guy in the middle is awful tough. Johnson, a rookie out of Colorado. Four linebackers. Bunny, Berge, he's something. LeMaster and Mahalik. Outlaw, Edwards, Logan, and Sanders play the pass defense for Philadelphia. The gain is only about a yard and a half. Second and 9. Theismann gives off quickly. Again, the Redskins try to run it right at the Philadelphia defense. Mike Thomas gets the call again. Mahalik knocked him down.
That's the type of play you like to run against that 34 defense. You try to get some movement. It's kind of a misdirection in a way because the fullback goes on one side and then Mike Thomas will cut back to the weak side after the flow of the linebackers.
We have 12 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the first quarter here at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. Now they send wide receivers out to the left side in Grant and Buggs. Go back the other way again to Thomas, and he runs into a bus. Charlie Johnson got him. Watch him play football. Johnson, and Lem Burnham was also on the play. And so the Redskins get nothing more than about 5 yards in their three plays from scrimmage, and they'll kick the ball back to the Eagles. Sonny?
That kicking game is going to be very important today. Field position, handling the ball, because down on the field before the game, Don, that wind is really whipping up, and it was tough to even throw the ball, and watching the quarterbacks warm up, they had a difficult time doing it.
Mike Bragg hits the ball very nicely. Had some wind with him. Larry Marshall will bring it back, and he's a good one. Marshall gets it back out to the 40, and a penalty marker goes down. We could have a clip against the Eagles on the return. Dallas Hickman was down on special teams.
We went a pretty good way without a penalty there. Both teams had the ball, their first possessions without a foul, and now we're going to get a clipping call on the second punt of the game.
Gene Barth, the referee. So the Eagles will be set back on the clip. 11:15 to play in the first quarter. Here's Gene Barth.
Personal foul, clipping number 58 on the run back, first down.
Terry Totolo, a linebacker out of UCLA, played for Dick Vermeil, the current Eagle coach in college. That was a 52-yard punt by Mike Bragg.
You can tell he had the win, huh?
That is a very tough wind to handicap, too. It's blowing every which way down there, swirling. Pitch back goes to Hogan on first and 10. And he is knocked down by Dyron Talbert and Harold McClinton. Redskins might be a little sore, Sonny, after coming off a Monday night game.
Yeah, they had that short week, and it makes it a little tough. Watch this little pitch back to Hogan. You get a lead block by Lusk over there on Mike Curtis, who gets him down. But Talbert, moving laterally, comes over and make the play. Good play by Dyron Talbert.
The gain was 4. It'll be second down and 6 now. Almost a 5-yard pickup where they have the ball marked up close to the 30. The handoff goes to Herb Lusk, who goes ahead maybe 3 yards on the counter. Herb Lusk is a second-year back out of Long Beach State, number 32. He was knocked down by Brundage and Dusick of the Redskins.
There he is, a dancing bear. Saw Ed George, the offensive tackle for the Eagles, in the dressing room before the game. I told him to be easy on McDowell today, and he says, are you kidding? He just amazes me just watching him. He was amazed every time I line up against him.
In his 17th year, big Ron McDowell. Third down and 2 now for the Eagles. did not get there. Redskins shut it right down. George Allen, with that computerized assessment of what the opposition's probably going to do, was looking for that.
Yes, they really jammed this up very well. Watch Ducey going in there. You see McDowell, all of them, everybody jams up good team defense because they do play tendencies very heavily. And they did a good job there. He's got to be pleased with the defense turning the ball back over to the offense.
Now Spike Jones is back in. He'll be banging it into the wind. He line drives it downfield. Eddie Brown comes up and fields the ball on the run at his 37. The channel of blockers is set to the right. They had blocks set, but good penetration is made. Larry Marshall came through, and Terry Totolo also did. And so the Redskins get their second possession as we still have no points up with 9:13 to play in the first quarter.
Introducing the Ford in your future, the new Ford Fairmont. A new car designed for today and the years ahead. At 33 miles per gallon highway, 23 city, Fairmont has the highest mileage ratings in its class. Yet it has 90% of the head, leg, and shoulder room of most large cars. And base sticker prices for the Fairmont line start at just $35.89. Fairmont, roomy but with mileage like a small car, and the lowest sticker price in its class. Test drive Fairmont, the newest better idea from Ford.
This is an Archer electronic smoke alarm from Radio Shack. It can save your life and property by detecting smoke
before it's too late.
And alerting you with a loud, continuous horn sound.
It's on sale now at only $21.88.
A small price to pay for so much peace of mind. Protect your home or business today with a low-cost Archer electronic smoke alarm. Only at Radio Shack, a Tandy company.
This telecast is presented by authority of the National Football League. It is intended for the private use of our audience, and any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Philadelphia Eagles and the National Football League is prohibited. Heisman and the Redskins go on offense for a second time. Again, they go to that darting run from Mike Thomas, trying to pick his way. What's the blocking on that? They keep running that play.
A little better. That time, he just kind of picks. This is an aggressive, straight-ahead block, and Haas did a good job. Then the right side of the line had a good block at the point of attack. He just looks for the daylight to run to, and they did a good job of it then. A little better field position than they had the first possession.
Second down in about six now. Weisman with a timing pattern lost the football. Might have been tipped. Hairston was coming hard from the left end. And Johnson's always coming hard from the middle guard.
I think he tried to pull it back, and he lost the grip on it. You see him blowing on his hands in. He was pumping the ball then, because Frank Grant had run a slant going back to the corner, and Joe wanted to pull it back in and reload, but the ball got away from him.
Eagles break the huddle again on defense as the Redskins align with two wide receivers set to the left. Heisman has people scattering, and he is picked off by Herman Edwards. That's an interception. He caught the football. Edwards, cornerback, at the ball. Rookie out of San Diego State.
This is a timing pattern. He tries to throw the turn in to Bugs. You see Bugs at the bottom of your screen just going out of the picture. Under a rush, LeMaster was running right down his throat. He threw the ball quickly. Danny planted. Couldn't come back. It's picked off by Edwards.
Sears National Automotive Values. From the people who brought you Die Hard batteries comes the Muzzler, the aluminized muffler from Sears. Only $19.99 installed. Sears announces a price rollback on the steel-belted Guardsman radio. Double steel toughness. And regular prices are reduced $36 to $68 a set at Sears.
Well, the weather up here is tough on everything.
You kind of feel good that you have a Die Hard.
You need a good battery in the city of Anchorage.
In Anchorage, they buy more Die Hards than any other battery.
I think the Die Hard was probably designed with Anchorage in mind.
Yeah, we depend on the Die Hard.
Turns that motor over just fantastic.
And so far, Sears Die Hard battery has been a good battery for me.
The Die Hard, with extra power to start your car when most batteries won't.
Turn the key over and it goes, you know that?
Sold only at Sears.
Tuesday night at 10, 9 Central Time, Lou Grant decides to investigate the competence of an eccentric judge. He gets a surpriser to himself. Watch Edward Asner as Lou Grant Tuesday night here on CBS.
It's an excellent show, isn't it?
It is very good.
Good acting.
And it's first and 10 now for Philadelphia at the Eagles' 46-yard line. No score on the board. We're in the first quarter. Don Cricky with Sonny Jurgensen, Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. Temperature's 37 degrees. And the wind is gusting up to 25 miles an hour. Jaworski puts it up, and the Eagles lose the ball right back to Jake. Oh! They said he didn't get it. He got it on the one hop.
Look at Jake. Jake's going into his...
Boy, I tell you, that was close.
Bird act there. I'd like to take a look at that. Let's take a look at that and see if we can see if it hits the ground. The ball gets away again from Jaworski. It sails on him. Let's see. I don't know. Hey, that's pretty close, Jake. I tell you, looks like he got his hands under the thing.
The official was right there.
The official was there. Close call.
So the Eagles get a big break as they very nearly turn it right back over to the Redskins after intercepting Theismann a moment ago. It is now second down and 10 for Philadelphia. No score in the first quarter. They go off to Hogan, and he cracks the crust and busts on through the Redskin defense down to the 40-yard line. Gain of about 14 yards.
Some good blocking in the middle of that line, and it's a little trap. They let Bill Brundage go. They let him run by the play. And he followed the guard. The guard pulled. He ran by the play. And that made the hole up front for Hogan. Good tough running.
Talbert looping a little bit to the outside, too. The play went right through. And
well, they blocked back on Talbert with the center. And
60.
Hoping that Brundage would follow the guard then.
The Eagles have a first down at the 40-yard line. Jaworski had the ball tipped, apparently, and he is knocked down. Here is a first quarter score from Shea Stadium in New York. The Seattle Seahawks out in front of the favored New York Jets, 7-0. Tell you, the pressure a lot of times now, Sonny, is on those teams playing the expansion teams because they're expected to win and they're feeling a little tight about it. I think a lot of teams go down to Tampa Bay like the Giants today, tight.
That's for sure. Look at this one. Buffalo leading Baltimore 7-0 in the first period.
You won't see O.J. Simpson playing there again next year, I don't think.
Well, he's indicated that he'd like to.
He'll be playing California. Second down and 10. Jaworski goes on a draw. Hogan gets to the outside, beats Curtis. Now Curtis gets an ankle high.
Boy, he's fast. He says he hasn't lost any speed from when he first came in the league. And he showed some of it then to cut back and chase down Hogan again. What a game that man had last Monday night. Had 11 unassisted tackles.
Well, the Redskin defense, they really kept him in it Monday night. Dancing Bear intercepted one. Fell to the earth with it. Wally Henry is now in as a wide receiver. They have him in a slot. They have three guys wide. Third and 10. Redskins came early. We'll see if they were drawn off. Good timing pattern thrown to Carmichael. But turned out short of the first down sticks.
Yes, they're coming up a little short here. Good pattern and a tough pattern to throw. Look at the sideline patterns. He has enough right there at the 30 for the first down, but he comes back, and by coming back to catch a ball, he comes up short of the first down. Having a little confab here to decide what they want to do, whether they're going to try to punt it, they're going to try a field goal. I think they're going for the field goal.
Well, it's a long one, and he's hitting it into the wind. Line of scrimmage is the 33. Be 7-yard mark off from there back to the 40. He's trying to hit it from 50 yards out. Now the Eagles want to call timeout. Roman Gabriel, who holds, very wisely calls a timeout. As the Redskins set up a defense that looked like it was going to come pouring right on through.
And that reception for Harold Carmichael was his 75th straight. The 75th straight game that he's had a reception. At least one pass. Isn't that amazing?
He's amazing. 6'8".
What a target.
A strong forward. The Eagles last week held New Orleans to only 166 yards total offense. And that was a week after the Saints had rushed for over 250 yards, rushing alone against the Los Angeles Rams. So the Eagles can play defense just like the Redskins can. The Eagles offense has turned the ball over too much. Next Sunday, lots more action as CBS coverage of NFL football continues. The Vikings and the Bears meet at Soldier Field in Chicago. Tampa Bay and Detroit play at Pontiac, Michigan. Atlanta and New Orleans at the Superdome. And Philadelphia in a big game goes against the Cardinals at St. Louis. Then the doubleheader action. You'll see either Dallas and the Steelers at Pittsburgh or Los Angeles at San Francisco. Doubleheader action next Sunday on CBS.
The Eagles have decided to go for it on fourth down.
Fourth and a long two. They've been running the ball well. They do it again. They get the first down. Backs picking their way through the Redskin defense. There's Chris Hamburger. He's very much missed. He's not been in much at all this year.
Ligament damage, and I tell you, he's tough time coming back, and I'm sure he'd like to be out there. Look at this cutback again. Hogan cuts back. The play was shut off at the point of attack, and he went back. Just a good piece of running on his part.
Eagles have a great right guard in Sizemore. You recall he's the best lineman in the country at Texas 6 years ago. And the center's good, too, Guy Morris. Sullivan takes a look, turns upfield, gets it down close to the 26-yard line. Coming up to make the hit, Jake Scott and Ken Houston.
It was a big gamble for the Philadelphia Eagles. They thought it was a smart call on their part because kicking the long field goal against the wind, if they miss it, the Redskins would have had the ball at the line of scrimmage anyway, so it was a pretty good gamble to try to go for the first down, and
That's
it paid off for them.
Now they send Carmichael out wide to the left. Matched against Lavender. Smith, who's much smaller but very quick, wide to the right. He's up against Gerard Williams. Warfield taking a look deep, got into the end zone. Carmichael looks at the football, gets a hand down it and loses it. He had Lavender looking like he was at a hoedown, turning around in circles.
They had him turned around, and you can see the trouble that the wind is causing with the football. He's throwing against the wind. You see the pattern. He runs a corner pattern. He's under a lot of pressure from Mike Curtis there. He had him beat, but look what happens. The ball is low and behind him, and again, the swirling wind had something to do with it.
Detroit has moved out in front of the Falcons, 6-0 at Atlanta, first quarter score. There's no score on the board here at Philadelphia. We have 5:25 to play in the first quarter. The Eagles with Ron Jaworski at quarterback in his fourth year from Youngstown State. First 3 years, you recall, at the Los Angeles Rams. He's got the gun arm. He can rifle it on a line into the end zone from this distance out. Fires in the flat. Carmichael turning out on Gerard Williams, and the connection is not made, and so we come up to fourth and long for the Eagles. Now Gabriel's coming out, and so is Horst Muehlmann.
I don't think anybody has a completion yet.
That's right.
I think it's 0 for 6 for Jaworski so far. Yes, he did. He had the completion on the short when they came up to Carmichael just short,
right.
Short
Turn
of the
out.
First down. That's right.
Muehlmann, a world-class soccer player from Germany. There's the distance in his leg to get it up. Oh, blocked by the Redskins. Those special teams that were introduced before the game make the big play as they've done time and time again.
Wendland Hall coming in for the block.
One of the Singer midgets could have blocked that, though. That was about 2 feet off the ground.
But the thing is, they were very slow in getting that ball off then, and that was the cause of it.
So we have a timeout here at Philadelphia, and still we have no score on the board. Nothing, nothing.
We're the Van Arsdales, Tom and Dick. We're identical twins, and we drink identical beers. Light beer from Miller. We love it. The best thing about light beer is it's less filling.
Great taste.
Less filling. It's got a third less calories than the regular beer.
Great taste, Tom.
Less filling. And I'm not Tom. You are.
Well, I'm Dick.
You think you
well,
are,
you
but you never were.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
Five on the 50-yard line!
Hey, Charlie, it was cold last night. You put in the Prestone and the freeze?
Prestone, Prestone. Who needs Prestone?
Prestone, Prestone? You need Prestone.
If your antifreeze is worn out or you don't have enough, you could be in trouble. So put in a fresh fill of Prestone, too, to prevent corrosion and freeze-ups.
Prestone, Prestone. We need Prestone.
Prestone, Prestone. You need Prestone.
The whole weekend.
Yeah, we'll go away.
Rhoda and Mike plan a weekend, but Ma kicks up a storm. You've got to be there. Rhoda, tonight at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Back at Philadelphia, first quarter, 5:14 to play in it. Eagles have just blocked Washington has just blocked an attempted field goal by Muehlman, and now the Redskins go on offense, first and 10. Nothing on the board. Thomas and Harmon, the setbacks. Thiessen now sends one man wide, goes on the quick out pattern. The ball is caught. The hit is quickly made by Johnny Outlaw. Danny Buggs swinging out.
A little short out pattern. Good first down call by Joe.
Down at Tampa Bay. The Giants have gone in front of the Buccaneers 7-0 in the first quarter. Tampa Bay 0-22 through their first season and a half in the NFL. The Steelers have just scored, and a Bradshaw to Lynn Swan pass to go in front of Cleveland, 7-3 at Pittsburgh. Great division. Well, great football, it looked like. No, and then it was held on. Thomas held on to the ball. Looked like he lost it from the way he's groping, but the hit was made very quickly by Charlie Johnson, who's an interesting story. Number 65, the middle guard for the Eagles. A Vietnam War veteran, then went to the University of Colorado. Wasn't drafted until the ninth round. And he's one of the best middle guards in the league right now in his first year.
As Wendland Hall picked up the Minnesota Vikings. Comes in and makes a big play for him.
Thomas with the trap blocking up front. Fights off one tackler. Gets very close to a first down.
Here's a little quick draw play. A little fast draw, kind of a trap join. You see the block in there, and he kind of loses his footing after breaking through in the open.
So it will now be a first down for the Redskins as they move the ball out to their 39-yard line. The clock running in the first quarter. 3:48 to play in it, no score.
I think that was their initial first down, wasn't it?
Might be. Grant is wide left. Eagles teeing off now, bringing their linebackers up tight on the outside as Thiessen gets time. Now here's where he can go. 40, 45. Slides into second with an 8-yard gain.
Safe. Wonder why he doesn't do a hook slide here. Let's take a look at this. The receivers recovered. Good coverage in the secondary. No one to go to. And this is what that mobility gives you. Ability to run back up the field with the thing, and very wisely he goes in. I didn't like his slide.
Who started that sliding? Was that Tarkenton?
I think Staubach and Tarkenton both did. I don't know who gets credit for it.
There is Thiessen, an out pattern. The ball is triggered out to Frank Grant, and it will be first down yardage. They had to get the ball out across the 50. They did that. Baltimore's now on the board up at Buffalo. Linhart hit a field goal.
21-yarder, yes, but then get them on the board in the first. 7-3. Buffalo's playing well since OJ's been hurt. They're having to compensate.
Makes everybody put up there figure there's, you know, 44 other guys in the football team. Again, they go to Mike Thomas, running up the middle into the Philadelphia defense. He is knocked down by Manny Sistrunk. The weather is very much football weather. Players like it. Tough to sit through. 37 degrees.
Who told you the players like it?
It's 37 in that, isn't it?
It's windy down there.
Windy, yeah. And there is a chance of rain. Second down and 8 now for the Redskins. They've advanced the ball, the deepest they have so far in the first quarter. Cross midfield, Thiessen has time. Penalty markers down as he puts it on the numbers of Danny Buggs at the 30. But a penalty marker went down in the Redskin backfield, and the Redskins were holding.
Boy,
so he got so much time.
That has plagued the Washington Redskins this year. Holding, holding, holding. You know that offensive lineman has that split second decision to make. Do I let my quarterback get killed, or do I hold?
Number 74, offensive holding.
Third start.
You know, Dick Vermeil came out with a strong statement about he doesn't like announcing the player's name
over the loudspeaker, the guilty party.
Came out with a strong statement about the officials not too long ago, but said that was his last one after he got hit for 1,000. Like Joe Green's crusade against the officials ended. Eagles come up and play the run hard. Nothing gained back after the penalty yardage of 10 is assessed. They go to the run, and the hit is made hard by Johnson first. And so it's going to be third down and 20.
This has been a fast first quarter. We're down to a minute 15 seconds in the first quarter. Very quick first quarter.
And the clock running. No score on the board. Washington nothing, Philadelphia nothing. Redskins coming into the game with a record of 4-4. The Eagles are 3-5, and four of their five losses. They were in position to score in the fourth quarter to win the game, but came up short. They're a better club in the 3-5 record. Here's Theismann putting it up, swings it out. The ball is tipped away from Clarence Harmon.
Randy Logan, and what a play he made. A diving play to knock the ball away at the last second. If he misses this ball, let's take a look at it. If he misses this, Harmon coming out of the backfield. Joe looking downfield. Gets good pass protection here. Stokes does a good job. You see a very accurately thrown ball. But look, if he misses this ball, he's going to be able to turn up the field with it.
Bragg hits another good punt downfield. Carries high. Larry Marshall, he catches it, and he meets right head on with Winland Hall, who's having a big day. He's going to get a game ball here. They win this one. He's blocked the field goal, and he's put the hit on Larry Marshall. Eagles go back on offense with nothing up yet.
With the price of most things going up, the sticker price of Pinto, the best-selling American small car, is coming down. As of October 3rd, new 78 model Pintos with more standard features will have a lower sticker price than last year's model comparably equipped. Important features are now standard, like AM radio, power front disc brakes, rear window defroster, tinted glass, and protective body side moldings. Ford Pinto, the best-selling American small car. Now more car for the money than last year. At Ford, the better ideas keep coming.
Excuse me, do they serve clams here?
No, and they don't serve turkeys either.
Pardon, monsieur. It's your clothes. You'd look better in Hager slacks. Or a Hager sport coat and slacks. Even a Hager vested suit. A variety of outfits at prices that are easy to swallow. Voila, monsieur. Table for one?
Make that a table for two.
Hager, because looking good makes you feel good.
We are back at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia with 43 seconds to play in the first quarter. The Eagles have the ball after their punt returner, Larry Marshall, was popped hard by Winland Hall. Just there it is.
His man Edwards didn't do a job for him, man. He let Winland Hall run free on him.
Maryland football fans remember Larry Marshall. He was the MVP for the Terrapins back in 1971, originally drafted by Kansas City. He's the Eddie Brown of the Eagles. Mike Hogan running and picking his way, comes out across the 25-yard line, close to the 29, a very good gain, about 9 yards on the pickup as McDowell and Gerard Williams were on the stop for Washington.
Good blocking by Herb Lusk then on Brad Dusick, tying him up. Didn't knock him off his feet, but Brad had to get tied up and spin out of it.
Here's a big game down at the Orange Bowl. Nothing between the Patriots and the Dolphins. New England could be adios if they lose today.
Yeah, that's big. They need that. They've been coming on, playing a little better. They did a job on Baltimore a couple of weeks ago. Seattle's leading the Jets now 7-0 in the first quarter. Jim Dorn, an 18-yard pass to Don Testerman.
Yeah, you could actually, in that AFC East, come out of that thing with an 11-3 record, not make the playoffs.
That's right.
The way it's breaking down right now. The first quarter just came to an end here at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia with the score Washington nothing and Philadelphia nothing.
Come on, Ali, come on. We're getting our picture taken.
Special moments. Times of your life you'll want to remember in pictures.
Smile, Howard. Smile.
To help make those pictures look as good as they can, make sure Kodak paper is behind them. If you don't see these words, it isn't Kodak paper. Just look for this sign when you get your pictures. Kodak paper, for a good look at the times of your life.
See, wasn't that fun?
Who is the number one investment firm in the East?
Who is the number one investment firm in the Midwest? Who is the number one investment firm in the South? Who is the number one investment firm in the West? You know who. Merrill Lynch. All around America, more investors turn to Merrill Lynch than any other investment firm. Sure, there are lots of investment firms, but there's only one Merrill Lynch.
Panasonic invites you to take a picture of a voice with a Panasonic cassette tape recorder.
Things was a lot different than it is now.
All with built-in mics. Some with built-in radios. There are pocket models.
It should last another 50 years.
And even some that record in stereo.
Say something. Come on, speak something.
So take a picture of a voice with Panasonic.
Say something, bark.
With Sonny Jurgensen, this is Don Crickey back at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. Eagles have the ball as we open the second quarter. There's no score. Ron Jaworski, the quarterback, opens up his backfield and an offset. Long left, they come back the other way as Herb Lusk runs hard. Not very far, though, as he crosses the 30. The big Redskins, and they are big. Brundage at 278 pounds knocked him down. The Eagles have a little advantage off the field. They've got the heated seats.
You see the feet, how they go. Have a heated bench, and you see those holes? They put their feet back in those holes. And you see what they do to the Redskins?
They won't even sit on it. It's so bad.
It's cold over there.
Very negative, says George. Won't even sit on that thing. Redskins are lying on the sidelines. They want to win a football game. So do the Eagles. This one might not see many points go up because they both play a lot of defense. On the run, Dyron Talbert and Bill Brundage converge on Hogan.
Watch the defense here move to the point of attack. You see everybody taking their little pursuit angles coming over. See Mike Curtis there just waiting to make sure that he goes in, and he just kind of observed that play. Baltimore is leading Buffalo 10-7 now. Lydell Mitchell got Baltimore ahead with a 6-yard run.
Redskins will enjoy a trip to Buffalo in December.
Uh-oh, a loose ball. A lot of people.
Almost. I don't know. The Redskins are trying to strip the ball. Carl Lorch, number 71, who's full grown.
Watch this now. Watch that closest ball comes getting lost right here.
Who wants that ball? Clinton wants that ball.
Oh, McClinton made a good play, didn't he? Played his blocker off.
Third down coming up now for the Philadelphia Eagles. Third and 4. The ball is at their 37-yard line. Wide left is Carmichael. In the slot to the left, Wally Henry. And wide to the right is Charlie Smith. Might be gunning it right over the middle. Might just dip that Henry in there. He takes a look. Jaworski took a look, and that was the end. He who hesitates. McDowell got him.
All right, good coverage. Excellent coverage, and didn't allow Jaworski to throw the ball. And there he goes. I can't understand. What's he doing back there with the quarterback? He talks about hanging around the line of scrimmage. You see the coverage here. You see the rush coming in. And who's behind him there? And a little help from Brundo. They're business partners, you know.
Snap back at an angle. They want to stay away from that wide rush. Mike Jones hits the ball high. But Eddie Brown will bring it back. Fast Eddie Brown gets it out across the 45-yard line, and there is a penalty marker down, two of them down, at about the 45-yard line of Philadelphia.
This is going to be a coverage violation. It looks like the one back at the line of scrimmage.
There's a holding signaled against Washington by an Eagle player. Now that doesn't count until we get it from a striped shirt.
That makes it an automatic first.
That's right.
Another break for the Philadelphia Eagles here.
Eagle offense is starting to come back out. We'll wait for the official word from Gene Bart.
Get a double foul. We'll replay the down. Ineligible man downfield for offense. Defensive holding. Replay.
Thank you, Gene.
Do it all over again. Eddie Brown drops back again. 5'11", 190, University of Tennessee. Degree in animal science. Care of Fisher's horses. Skins were coming hard. The The ball is drilled downfield, and Eddie Brown takes it back at his 20, and he could have a problem right now. Eddie Brown is chopped at the 27-yard line. And there the Redskins will go on offense, first and 10.
They got some people down on the field, and we could have a couple of injuries here.
Two Eagles were laid down hard on that play. We'll have a timeout now.
Introducing a new 1978 Ford Granada, the ESS. Can you tell it from this impressive $20,000 Mercedes 280 SE? Granada. Mercedes. Granada. Mercedes. Granada. Mercedes. The new Ford Granada ESS. See how close you can come to the look of a $20,000 Mercedes at the price of a Granada. When America needs a better idea, Ford puts it on wheels.
There's this big argument going on about light beer from Miller.
Right.
Some guys argue the best thing about it that it's less filling.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's true.
It has a third less calories than their regular beer. Other guys say the best thing about it is its great taste.
Here, here.
I feel very strongly both ways. After all, I'm not the kind of a guy who ever gets into an argument.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
Next Saturday at 4:30 Eastern Time, 3:30 Central, it's the CBS Sports Spectacular, an outstanding lineup of programming televised live from Milan, Italy. Victor Galindez, the world light heavyweight boxing champion, defends his title against Eddie Gregory of Brooklyn, who says he's the hottest thing in Brooklyn since the Dodgers. Galindez has not been beaten in his last 34 bouts. And then a big thoroughbred event, the Turf Classic, over a mile and a half for three-year-olds and up. Some of the top horses in the country, Johnny D, Majestic Light, Exceller, all entered in that one. And then the World's Strongest Men competition. This weekend they'll be picking up cars. That's next Saturday on the CBS Sports Spectacular. Pitch back quickly to Thomas. Eagles greet him. Drew Mahaley picks the play. Drew Mahaley, who co-captained a national championship team at Notre Dame, coming up from the outside linebacker, makes the hit behind the line.
Boy, what a defensive play here by the Eagle defense. John Bunning coming over. You see Thomas, no place to go, goes back the other way. There's Mahalik has him, and Harrison comes in. A lot of people around that football. Pittsburgh now gone up 14-3 over Cleveland in the second period.
They own the Browns at Three Rivers. Browns haven't won there in 7 years. Theismann takes a look, darts outside. He can go. He bails out. But he got back a lot of the lost yardage. They'd lost 10 yards in the previous play, and Theismann came back on the run to gain about 13 or 14.
He's going to be the
Bunning ran him out.
He's going to be the leading ground gainer. George has got to be concerned about what's taking place. He wants to see more offense. That's what he's wanted to see all year. Here it is again. Good coverage again in the secondary. You see Berge coming around on a blitz.
Picked him off nicely.
Joe comes back.
You know you don't want to get hit by that 65.
It's a long run for those defensive linemen. Good smart play getting out of bounds. Look at that, two rushes, 22 yards.
The third and six is coming up now for the Redskins at their 31. Theismann has time. He throws. He's got a first down. Mike Thomas swung out of the backfield, held his ground, waited for the defense to open up. It did. It spread out, and then Theismann put it on his numbers. Mahalik knocked them down, but it's a first down for the Redskins. They their best play so far.
They did. Good call and a good possession type pass. Both backs out of the backfield hooking up, and he took his choice reading the defense. Went to the right man.
These teams very evenly matched. They both give up about the same amount of yardage on defense.
That was Mr. Talbert talking to Bill Brundage.
Theismann to put it up again. Now the pass coverage breaks down, and Theismann goes down at the 37-yard line. Carl Hairston, big guy out of Maryland Eastern Shore, 78 was the first guy. And Charlie Johnson, the middle guard, was also on the play. Now the Dolphins have gone in front of New England in the second quarter.
Yeah, it was a one-yard run by Gary Davis.
Whoever he is.
Yes.
One of those new backs at Miami. He can play, apparently. Dolphins go into that game 6-2, New England 5-3. And, of course, New England's without its all-pro tight end Russ Francis for about a month. The Buffalo Bills not only beat the Patriots, they broke some of the big guys' ribs.
That's right.
Second and 12, they go to a draw. And on the run is Clarence Harmon.
Going to have to go upstairs with it again here.
Charlie Johnson was on the stop. Johnson wasn't drafted until the ninth round out of Colorado. He comes out now as they put their pass rush unit in. Pete Lazatich, big nose tackle out of Stanford, in the lineup.
Talking to Len Haas about Lazatich, and he says there's no break when Pete Lazatich comes in the game.
Heisman takes a drop, puts it up. Oh, that very nearly was the Philadelphia Eagles. Randy Logan had his hands on the ball, and Mike Thomas came over and might have knocked it away. Very nearly a second interception, so Mike Bragg comes back out as the Eagle defense stops the Redskin offense again. And still with no score on the board, Philadelphia will get it back here in the second quarter.
Let's see what Mike Bragg likes to do here, kicking against this strong wind.
He's standing at his 26-yard line. Good snap and a good punt. He really ripped one into the rim. Marshall back inside the 20. Look at the Redskins cover. Boy, this special team's come down. About eight guys get a lick on you.
They had eight guys on the football end. Eight guys. Two people were back, and there's one over to the right. Eight of them on that football.
There's a hold signal, though, against the Philadelphia Eagles on the play.
That'll be a first down.
Yep, here come the Redskins back out on offense. Ted Fritsch was the first man down. What does George do to get those guys to play such great special teams?
He emphasizes it. It's a major part of the practice schedule. A lot of teams don't emphasize it. I think George was the first to emphasize it as much as he did. And by putting so much emphasis, they...
Defensive holding, number 49, before the kick, first down.
Eric Johnson got called for the hold. But putting so much pressure, you see Billy there. Looks like he's a little cold, doesn't he? Told him to get him a hot dog. A cup of coffee and a hot dog on the sideline.
The Redskins get the first down and a penalty, and now they come back to the smashing run, but there's a free football, and Thomas lost the ball, and the Eagles get it. So the subsequent play after the good special teams coverage by the Redskins actually cost them a lot of ground. They're having to hold one of the Redskins off. Mike Thomas.
He didn't think he'd fumble.
You can't get it back now, Mike. It's gone.
That was the first time I've seen Mike. He made an excellent move to get on the run then. He came up and fumbled the ball. Hey, I'm sure he's upset about it. It's obvious.
So the Eagles will get the ball, and here is probably an unsportsmanlike conduct, and that's a big one. 15 yards. There it is.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, number 22, first down.
So Thomas lost the ball and an additional 15 yards with...
He compounded the
felony
mistake.
So now with the fumble recovery and the subsequent penalty, the Eagles have their best field position down to the 36-yard line, the best field position of the second quarter. Still no score on the board. The handoff goes to Mike Hogan. Got to work for those running yards against the Redskins as Mike Thomas puts his gloves on and tries to get it together.
He's just, you know, nobody likes to make a mistake like that. And being in a contest like this, highly emotional contest, and then what happens? You say something to an official and you've made two mistakes.
Yeah. Second down coming up now for Jaworski and the Eagles. The ball at the 33-yard line. Washington. First back through is Hogan. Boy, they're getting some trap blocking, ripping the Redskins front four. They're getting the linebackers going at the flow, and then they're trap blocking.
Their offensive line really coming off on the ball. Let's take a look. You see Hogan just takes a little lead step. George does a good job on the outside on McDowell because the play looked like it was going wide, and that's what they wanted, and Hogan just cut back against the grain a little bit.
Mike Hogan's a 210-pound fullback from Tennessee at Chattanooga in his second year. He's coming off a knee injury, kept him out of game. Sullivan Hogan, two lower-round draft choices. Now they go right back to Hogan, and the Redskins read it, and this time they don't let him cut back.
Not only did they read the plate, Don, but they overshifted the line that way. And Jaworski couldn't get out, get to an audible. I'm sure he's concerned about that. He ran right to the strength of the defense.
That time, Curtis didn't go wide. Look at that guy going out. He went right in and made the hit along with Dusick. Full complement of Eagle coaches. That's Vermeil, the head coach, with the headset on. He's got a fired-up team.
You're talking about the number of losses they've had. Five losses. Four of them have been within 6 points.
Jaworski play faking, loops the ball up, Sullivan is there, and it's touched down. No markers, but we can see the play will go. Beautifully done. Jaworski froze the defensive back with the play fake, and then dropped back, and Sullivan was cruising.
And excellent call, and he did. He fooled the defense in completely because somebody should have been with Tom Sullivan.
Boy, they had that one working. That was right off the blackboard. Eagles go 36 yards after the fumble recovery and then the penalty, you'll recall, of 15 yards for unsportsmanlike conduct. That's what set it up. 36 yards in four plays. Horst Moorman will try the point after. It is up and good. And so we have 7 minutes and 16 seconds left to play in the first half. And the Philadelphia Eagles have put the first points up. They lead the game 7-0.
It's our house.
Except for the insurance and closing.
Oh, well, what insurance company?
Ah, they're all the same.
Allstate's different.
Different? How?
We give a 10% discount for newer homes.
Oh?
It's a 10% discount.
Now 10% off our rate.
On basic homeowners insurance for houses 5 years old or less.
Allstate's different, all right.
Good hand.
Oh, boy.
When it takes being different to be better, Allstate will do it.
That's a promise from us, the good hands people.
Announcing a unique new motor oil from Exxon Research that can actually save money. New Golden Natural Uniflow. Uniflow was tested in cars like yours. After break-in, it delivered an overall average of 16 extra miles per tank full. Savings like that could cut your gasoline bill the equivalent of about 3 cents a gallon. New Uniflow motor oil is Exxon's best engine protection ever. It conserves gasoline, saves money.
Sorry to bust up the game, fellas, but I'm Barbara Rhodes, and I thought you might like my address and my number.
Busting loose Wednesday at 8:30, 7:30 Central and Mountain.
Dick Vermeil, and the Eagles get the first points of the game as Jaworski loops one up and Sullivan runs under it, beat the linebacker covering. And the Eagles go in front 7-0 with 7:16 to play in the first half. Muehlman kicks off, not too deep. Eddie Brown brings it across the 20. Across the 30, and Eddie Brown has finally run out of bounds. Coming down to get him was Martin Mitchell.
Let's take a look at that touchdown play again. Watch your good fake. Jaworski's already going back fake, and you'll see right here trailing the play, Mike Curtis. Kenny Houston came over to throw a shot at him, but Curtis got beat. He's so aggressive, and he likes to get in there and hit people. I told you last time about let's get in a defense where I can hurt somebody. And he was over-aggressive then, and it cost him.
That's what Curtis said?
Yes.
Theismann puts up a timing pattern, but too high for Frank Grant. It'll be second down and 10 for the Redskins at their 35. A big CBS Sports special is coming up next Friday night at 11:30 p.m. Eastern Time. You will see unbeaten heavyweight Leon Spinks, the gold medal winner from the Montreal Olympics, taking on the unbeaten Italian heavyweight champion Alfio Righetti. That is live from Las Vegas at 11:30 Eastern Time. Next Friday night, here on CBS.
And Righetti has 14 knockouts.
He can hit. Look at Spinks. Eagles might have encroached. Markers go down. Ball is put up. Incomplete at the 50, but the Redskins might get penalty yardage here as it looked like the Eagles jumped early.
Think it did. They went into that zone and couldn't get back out of it.
They're now in the second quarter at Orchard Park, New York. Baltimore opening up over the Bills after falling behind 7-0 in the first quarter. The Colts looking to annex their eighth win. Now up 17-7. Lydell Mitchell got
number 78.
He's had two touchdown runs. One, last one, 18 yards.
It'll be second down and five after the penalty against Philadelphia. Eagles got a little anxious as they tee up now their front three. Three down linemen. They almost play a five-man front a lot of the time because the linebackers are up so tight on the outside. Look, it's a five-man line, really. 5-2 at the boys' end. Free football, but there's penalty markers down also. I think the play might have been dead. Looks like it's going to be a hold again against the Washington Redskins unless the play was still going because Theismann lost it.
They call holding. But let's see if Theismann loses the ball. Let's watch this thing. Here he goes back. He gets a rush here. Right here is where he loses the ball. And that ball is down. Oh. I tell you, they have a right. They're booing here in Veterans Stadium. They have a right to. He did lose. The ball got knocked out of his hand. They wanted to play.
Offensive holding. Number 74 refused.
Big
third down.
Big break for the Redskins there.
George Stark, who was called for holding earlier, gets one negated as the penalty is refused.
They apparently did not think that he had fumbled the ball and the play had been blown dead, but he was still scrambling and moving a little bit when the ball was knocked out of his hands.
Third down. 13. Theismann throws long. Grant's going for the ball. Edmund Edwards bumped in a little bit, but apparently it's Rooley who's going for the football, and so it goes as a long out, and the Redskins will have to punt the ball back to Philadelphia. The Eagles are coming out, shaking fists in the air. It's some foot thunder coming down from sold out Veterans Stadium now.
Yes, it is.
Crowd of about 66,000 is here. And there is Mike Bragg in to punt the ball.
Boy, he hit a big one last time. Two punts so far. Look at the 44. That's more than he averages.
Ehlers was coming hard looking to block it. Bragg is even hitting the ball well into this gusting wind. Larry Marshall takes it. Darts ahead. And a penalty marker goes down. Usually a clip against the return team.
Yes. How many times do you see any punting play, any tape play? There's more flags on punts than anything else.
There's a lot of guys who can fake getting clipped pretty well.
Yes, you practice that.
Only way to get easy yard.
Well, it's easy to turn when the man is hitting you from the side to turn a little bit, and therefore he gets into the back of your legs, and he's called for clipping. That was a 36-yard punt against the wind that time.
Personal foul. Clipping number 31 on the run back. First down.
Wilbert Montgomery. Larry Marshall's running mate when they returned punts was the man who was called for the clip. And so the Eagles with a 7-0 lead will go on offense first and 10 at their 21.
The closer you shave, boy.
The closer you shave, boy.
The more you will need.
The more you will need.
Great balls of comfort.
Great balls of comfort.
To do it with ease.
Great balls of comfort.
Oh, just like Noxzema.
Noxzema. Great balls of comfort to you.
The closer you shave, the more you need soothing, medicated Noxzema.
Great balls of comfort to you. Woo!
For the millions of people who need a full-size car, introducing the 1978 Ford LTD. If you need six passenger space, if you need a roomy trunk, if you want mileage like this, then the full-size 1978 Ford LTD could be just the car for you. LTD, a better idea from Ford.